Jesus 101, a manual for young Christians. So hanggang lesson 2 po tayo. So guys, everyday po tayong maggagalito. So kada isang araw po ay meron po akong tuturong lesson sa inyo. Dalawang lesson or isa. So guys, ito po yung Jesus 101. Ang nakalagay po sa baba ay a manual for young Christians. So, ito po. So, ang gumawa po sa libro na to ay yan, copyright or 2019 by Pentecostal Missionary Church of Christ, yan, Fort Lodge. So, all rights reserved. So, nakalagay po dito, all rights reserved. No part of this book may be reproduced or used in any manner without written permission of the copyright owner except for the use of quotations in the book review. So, pwede ko po sa iyo to guys i-explain, pero po, bawal ko po ipakita yung mismong laman ng book na to po. Kasi po, copyright na po yun. So, yun. So, ito po yung forward ng book. Hello, young Christians! Welcome to the first ever Jesus 101, a manual for young Christians made especially for you, para sa atin po. The Bible teaches obedience to God's word in this manual. You will learn how to grow spiritually by following God's commandments and to be good Christians. Remember that as Christians, you should obey God. Following God's teaching can be challenging at times, but now that God is your potter and you are the clay, you are being molded and sharpened according to the person he wants you to be. A good amount of pressure will be shaped the lump of clay. So enjoy the process and see the beautiful person that you will become as you obey Jesus Christ. By Dr. Lucia Santos. So ang lesson mo natin ay accepting Christ, believe, repent, and to be baptized. So, po ang lesson mo. As human beings, we have sinned and fell short of the standard for entering heaven. But because God loves us so much, He sent His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from eternal punishment. John, 1 John 4, verse 9. So, claim your spot in heaven as you follow this step-by-step guide. So, ito po based sa 1 John 4 verse 9 yung binasa natin kanina. So, at nakalagay na po dito, claim your spot in heaven as you follow this step by step guide. So, step number 1. Yeah, have faith, believe that Christ died for you because of His great love, He saved you from your sins. So, sabi po dito sa John 3:16. Siyempre, kailangan nating maniwala. So, pangalawa po, repent, be truly sorry for your sins, and follow Christ's teachings. Sabi po sa Acts 20, verse 2. So, be baptized. Baptism cleanses you and makes you a new person that is more like Christ. Sabi sa 1 Peter 3, verse 20. Then, so, meron pong prayer dito, nakalagay. Say this prayer sa baba. So, let us pray po daw. Dear God, thank you for loving me even though I have sinned today. I accept Jesus Christ as my Savior and coming King. Amen. Yan, to summarize ang lesson natin dito, ang step 1, believe. Yon, maniwala ka kay Jesus. Kay God, yan. So, believe Christ died for us. So, namatay siya para sa atin. Yan. So, step 2, repent yung magsisisi. Yan. Sa ating mga kasalanan. Siyempre, lahat ng tao may kasalanan. So, step number 3, be baptized yung baptism. Yan. Guys, so, ito po ang lesson 2 from the book Jesus 101. So, God's 10 commandments ang pag-aaralan natin sa lesson 2. Yan. So, sabi po sa Exodus 20 verse 2 to 17, God gave us the 10 commandments to guide us in living a Christian life. Yan. So, ang 10 commandments natin ay first commandment is you shall have no other gods before me. Yan. So, at number 2 ng commandments, you shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above or on the earth beneath or in waters below. Third commandment, you shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not hold anyone guiltless who misuses his name. Fourth commandment, remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. So yung Sabbath day po, yung mag-worship po tayo sa Sunday. So, fifth commandment, honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you. Yan, so, parang ano, obey your mother and father. Yan, so, para gagalangin po sila. Yan, so, ang nakalagay po dito, Sabbath is the day for the Lord, yung explain ko po. Sabbath is the day for the Lord in the Bible, the first day of the week, which is Sunday, should be dedicated for Him. Don't forget to go to church on this day and to listen to God's Word. So, yan. So, sabi po dito pupunta po sa church. Pero, right now, pandemic po. Make sure lang po natin ay umatin ng live ng ating church. At, pag wala na po ang pandemic, pwede na po tayong pumunta sa ating simbahan. Yan. So, sixth commandment, you shall not murder. Yan. Bawal pumatay. Seventh commandment, you shall not commit adultery. So, guys, sa Tagalog po ng adultery, bawal man niya. Sorry po. Yeah, so, 8th commandment, you shall not steal. Bawal mo na. 9th commandment, you shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. Yan, bawal pong magsabi ng gawa-gawang salita. In short, bawal si Jesus. Yan, so, 10th commandment, you shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife or his manservant or maidservant, his ox or donkey or anything that belongs to your neighbor. Yan. So, sabi, parang ito rin po yung 8th commandment. So, as followers of Christ, you must obey His commandments. For doing so means that you love and honor God's teaching. If you follow Christ's footsteps, you will never fear again, for God will always protect you. So let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, please watch over me. Make me a faithful and obedient follower so I can glorify you with everything I do. So guys, ayun na po ang ating lesson for the day. Lesson 1. Lesson 2 sa Jesus 101. Yan. So, yan. So, no copyright po. Bawal po mag-copyright. Yan. So, yun po. Yan. So, please subscribe on my YouTube channel, Hit the Notification. see you on my next lesson. God bless. Bye.